Hi everyone, my name is Daisy. In this presentation, I will talk about the impact of regulations on kiwi fruit industry. Kiwi seeds were introduced to New Zealand from China in 1904. In 1927, New Zealand Hayward Wright cultivated a new variety of kiwi fruit. It's called Hayward Kiwi, and it's been a standard variety of kiwi fruit for export. In October 2013, the Kiwi Fruit Industry Strategy Project, KISP, was established to jointly develop a strategy to maximize the industry ability and realize the long-term market of the kiwi industry. Kiwi Fruit is the largest single horticulture outlet in New Zealand with volume and value. In 2016, the exports exceed $1 billion. New Zealand over 2,500 growers produce about 140 million pellets for export. The operation of kiwi industry is complex and difficult. In order to achieve the industry maximum benefit and sustainable development, there are different regulations and organizational management to apply in the whole supply chain. This presentation will mainly talking about five stages: production orchard, trucking company, processor, exporting, shipping, warehousing, and retailer. Kiwi fruit production, fertilizer use and research supported by the August research program under the Agriculture Compounds and Veterinary Medicine Act 1997. And Zespri is the commercial partner for the August program. The August research program suggest annual nutrient requirements for maintaining the yields on established Hayward kiwi fruit vines. In addition to regulations on biological growth, Zespri also put forward regulations on employee in the Global Supplier Code of Conduct. As the future growth of new kiwi fruit industry depends on the attracting and retaining those highly skilled young people and development as the future leader. In 2000, the New Zealand Kiwi Fruit was restructured through the Kiwi Fruit Restructuring Act 1999 and Kiwi Fruit Export Regulation 1999. The Act established Zespri Group Limited and provide for making regulations. KNZ as an independent statutory monitors Zespri annually to ensure that it meets non-diversification rules. In the rule, it includes responsible justifiable discrimination, include product character, quality, quantity, time, place, risk, or potential. Zespri is committed to provide high quality and safe kiwi fruit throughout all their brands. According to Zespri Code of Conduct, Global Supply Code of Conduct, suppliers need to comply all the regulations in production, packaging, storage, and transportation. New Zealand is the largest kiwi fruit exporter, is accounting for about 47% of the global kiwi fruit export. The Kiwi Fruit Industry Restructuring Act 1999 and the Kiwi Fruit Export Regulation 1999 established Zespri as a company as the main exporter to overseas, except for Australia. Such arrangement is also called single point of entry or single desk. Single point of entry helps kiwi fruit industry only need to focus on the marketing needs, so maximum the value comes from the market. Currently, Zespri in China market sales reach 80,000 tons, accounting for 18% of Zespri's global sale. With an increasing variety of imported food in China, the regulate of imported safety in becoming complicated. In 2015, April 24, China passed the newly revised food safety law and food import export measures. The new law was implemented in October 1st, 2015. According to the new law, overseas food producer and exporter need to be responsible for the quality and the safety of the food. The new law also provides more detailed imported standards for Chinese importers. Desperately, as after being examined by Chinese new food safety law, the green image of kiwi fruit in China has further improved. This has not only helped the kiwi fruit industry expansion in China, also helped improve the reputation of New Zealand. A mixed challenge and opportunities faces desperately and kiwi fruit growers in the coming 5 years as the grape with the A grapple with the continued bite of PSA disease. The marked uncertain production level and the looming threat of other competition. Asian demand means China provides enormous opportunity for Zespri to fill the market. Meantime, Zespri picked the greatest threat from China as well, as the country's ability to growth quality growth improved. In conclusion, the kiwi supply chain has a completely law system governing the industry from orchard stage to overseas retailer, allowing the industry to develop sustainable. As a professional group limited, Zespri has achieved great success in the past 10 years as current regulation system, good governance, and the adequate performance measure. But each regulation still exists some disadvantage. For example, NPR is concerned will not go far enough to address the review finding with respect to collaborative marketing, particularly the issues relating to the disadvantage of short-term approvals. So in the future, Zespri can continue to develop the more high-quality kiwi fruit by research and development. At the same time, Zespri need to continue enhance the effectiveness of its stakeholders' participation, work with the growers, collaborative marketers, and other organizations to developing and complete the regulation of the kiwi fruit.